Hi friends, welcome back to my channel and today's video. So the Swedish word of the day is food, which is in Swedish, mat. Mat. I am so freaking hungry right now, so I cannot wait to just finish this video up and then sit down and eat. I'm hungry AF. Anyway, in today's video, I am doing a little collaboration with my friend Jessica, or Stars Hollywood Jessica, as you might know her as. Jessica is a wonderful person and she's also a Swede. Jessica is an amazing woman. I really, really like her and I have recommended her to so many of you guys in the DMs and like on my channel, like DMs on Instagram I'm talking about. And so many of you have actually said to me that you feel inspired to start your own channel because of the way she does her channel. Just because of the fact that she has her channel very, very simple. Minimal editing, long videos, and very take it as it is. And you take her as you wish. Like, you know, I come on my channel and I always have makeup on. That's not always the case with her. She's very, very real. She's a person that buys everything. And I don't mean that in a negative way, but she has like everything. She has it all. If you are wondering about a palette or so on, she has it. She has over 1,500 palettes now, I think it is. Yes, that is true. I think that I have a lot, but I mean, she has a lot. So I will of course link her down below so you can go ahead and check her out. I really, really would like you to subscribe to her if you like her little channel. Anyway, today we are going to talk about some makeup that we like that other people doesn't like. This is hard, you guys. This is really, really hard. I have done a video like this in the past, but I feel like it's way more easier for me to talk about makeup that other people like that I don't like. But it's way more harder to find out or find products that's despised, but that I love. But I did make a little list, so we are going to go through the products in this video. Oh my god, I did forget to say this, I'm just gonna say it. So I did film this look, I think it is up on Instagram. The eyes are up on Instagram anyway, and then I did a little separate IG tutorial for the face, but that is gonna be up later on. I don't really know when, maybe in 2 weeks or so, I don't really know. Anyway, I did use this palette. This is from I Heart Revolution and it's so freaking cute. This is what it looks like. I did actually in my little review or first impression review compare it to the Melt Smoke Sessions palette. But the reason why I thought about this is because when I saw that Makeup Revolution had launched this palette, I actually just screenshot it and then sent it off to Jessica because Jessica buys most of the things that Makeup Revolution comes out with. And I just DM'd her and I said, you are the only person that will understand why I'm obsessed with this. So she bought it instantly and she has it now as well. And yeah, I just thought I would mention that because now that I see this, I will always think about Jessica. Anyway, let's get into this video. And the first thing that I personally like that not a lot of people like is the Gerard Cosmetics liquid lipsticks. These are drying, but I do want to make a little disclaimer that the darker shade, all of the darker shade that I have purchased are crap. They are patchy, they are uneven, and they are just not the same quality as these ones. I will also say I don't wear these that much anymore just because of the fact that the shades aren't really my cup of tea. But the formula I really, really like. As I said, they are a little bit drying. Yes, they are, but they stay on the entire day. They are kiss proof. I remember first time wearing these, I actually, it was laying on the side. And I wore these actually to a New Year's party. It wasn't like the first time I was wearing it, but it was just like I wore it because I knew that I didn't want to reapply my lipstick all the time. And I don't think I reapplied it any time, or I just replied it like maybe one time. So I really, really like them and I don't really think that they are that uncomfortable. And if I wear them during the winter, I just apply a little bit of lip balm, just a thin, thin, thin layer, and then they glide on and they are super comfortable. So these ones, yes. Oh, I forgot to do a little bit of a disclaimer, so I'm just gonna do it now. But a lot of people will comment that I have heard a lot of people maybe liking this or maybe liking that or whatever, or I like that one. Yes, but I'm just talking in general of the assumption that I have. I have the assumption that not a lot of people like this. Maybe it is because I watch different people than you, and the people that I have watched and have spoken up about the products that I am talking about today, they don't like it. So that's just why I'm saying the way I am. I might not be correct, but that is the assumption that I have. Okay. The next product I wanted to talk about is actually this little sponge. It is disgusting because I used it today, but it is the EcoTools sponge. I know a lot of people that likes the shape, but doesn't like the actual sponge. I don't really know why. I like it. I don't have a problem with this. I really like it. The main issue I have with it is that it kind of breaks very, very easily. So you have to be very gentle. You can see that mine has like bumps in it. I don't really care. Like, it works, it's fine, whatever. I have repurchased this a couple of times and I will keep on repurchasing it because I think that it's worth it. That's just the way it is. So I want to talk a little bit about an eyeshadow palette that got a lot of drama and a lot of people didn't like this, but you can see that I did like this palette, and that is the Morphe Bling Boss palette. I know that there was such a controversy when talking about this palette and the entire vault and everything, and yes, I get it. I was also pissed and I wasn't going to purchase anything, but then, you know, the hype got to me and I did pick it up. And I don't regret it because you can see that I have gotten quite a lot of use of this palette. You know, Bling Bling was my go-to inner corner highlight for such a long time. And then Rockstar is like the most beautiful matte purple deep plum. These foils in this palette is insane. They are so blinding, but they're not glittery. They are just kind of that wet look. Let me swatch Ballsy for you as well, which is, whoop, it's this one. It doesn't look that impressive in the pan, but it has this beautiful like grayish pinky, I don't know how to explain it, rosy tone to it. It's really, really pretty actually. Yeah, but I really like them. All of the shades I do like. Well, I will say this, okay, I have my favorites in this palette. So I don't think I've ever used Pissass. I don't think I have probably used Sparks a couple of times, but not that much. And then Gem has a little bit of a different formula than the other shimmers, but the shimmer or the shades that I like in this palette, I have used so much. It's the same thing with this Hush Hush. It looks like it's not that impressive, but it actually is. It is this most beautiful transition shade. And I remember I wore this all the time, but I did the same look all the time, and I reached for this palette so many times to use this Bling Bling shade. I don't know if the quality is different on mine than others, because I did actually see some people use their shimmers and they were like trash, and I mean, I don't really know what happened there, but I like my palette. And yeah, that's an unpopular opinion. Another thing that got really, really bad publicity was a product from Sigma. This is their cheek and blush palette, or blush cheek palette. So this is what it looks like. It comes with a big mirror as well, but we all know how a mirror looks like. And yeah, this is what it looks like inside. I will say I don't love all of the shades, but I do like these three, mainly use these two, mainly actually this one. But I heard a lot of people that didn't like this palette because they said that it was kind of, I don't know. I don't really know what they said, but I bought it. I didn't get sent this from Sigma. I am a Sigma affiliate, but I did not get sent this palette. I bought it by myself. Sigma never sends me their newest releases. I think it is because I don't promote my code that well. So I sell real, really bad for them, but it's fine. Anyway, I think that this palette is good. I don't think I would repurchase it, however, but it's only because of the shades. If you love these shades, then I stand for the quality. They are pigmented, but they are not like super duper pigmented. Like, this is just a little swatch of them, so you can kind of build them up. And I don't know, like, I don't know why people didn't like this, but I just know that they didn't. But I do. Same thing with this palette. This was their Sculpt and Highlighting Palette. No, Sculpt, Highlight, and Contour Palette. And this is what this looks like. I will say, like, of course, these three are too deep for me, but I mainly use this shade, and I actually don't know what people's problems were. Like, I understand if you don't like certain shades, yes, but a lot of people said that it was patchy, it was too dry and everything, and it definitely has like a more, both of the palettes actually have a more packed, like it's tighter packed, doesn't have a lot of kick up and such. I mean, I actually use this quite a lot and you cannot see a single dent in it, but I like it. It doesn't go patchy on me. Sometimes, you know, I don't always set my face, so sometimes, you know, it can get a little bit patchy right here, but I just need to focus on my blend. But it kind of depends on where I put or where I place my brush and then kind of go ahead and blend it out. Sometimes I need to work with it, but I need to work with it when it comes to all contour palettes when I haven't set my face. You know how powder products can be over a wet base? So that's not like the palette's fault, it happens with everything. So yeah, I don't really know why people just kept hating on it. Same thing here, if I could repurchase it, then I probably wouldn't, but I wouldn't repurchase most of my contour palettes because I don't use most of the shades. Like, it's not a lot of value in it. Next product is the Cover FX Custom Enhancer Drops. I know that these used to be very hyped, but now I feel like a lot of people kind of hates on them. A lot of people says that they are very, very glittery, and sure enough, they are. I'm just gonna do a little swatchy swatch so you can see them. I'm kind of a little bit shocked that mine aren't like super empty, because I've had these for a long time and I've actually used these quite a lot, but you don't need a lot of product. I use it to this day. Sometimes I add it into my foundation if I want it to be a little bit more illuminating and sheer. But this is the shade Celestial and this is Sunlight. So here you can see them. They are super like metallic, super beautiful. I really like them, and I did have a phase where I always, like always, used them, and I applied like a small drop right here on my cheekbone, and then I applied highlight on top of it. Now I don't do that anymore because I feel like I can spray my brush and get kind of the same effect, because if I apply that and then I apply an highlighter on top of it, that highlight that I apply on top of it is gonna take all of the focus. But it is a good way to kind of intensify your highlight if you like that sort of look. But I like them, and I don't get why people say that they are super duper glittery, because I mean, yes, they are a little bit glittery, but they aren't like that super glittery. I like them anyway, and I like the kind of thing that they do. So my last product is an eyeshadow palette, and this is my favorite product out of this entire video. I did even go on Instagram and ask you guys if you wanted me to purchase it, or not if you wanted me to purchase it, but if you recommended it, and most people said no, it's not that great. I couldn't get my eyes off it and I couldn't get it off my mind, so I did go ahead and repurchase it, and it's the Urban Decay Moondust palette. I don't know how many people of you have actually gone out and purchased this palette because I recommended it, but it's such an amazing palette. It is super expensive for what you, or the, like, how to say it, but it is an expensive palette just because you only get like 8 shades. However, it's worth it and I would repurchase it. Hands down. This green shade, I would repurchase it only for this. I've worn this in so many tutorials. I've worn it so many times off camera, to work, to an event. Not, I don't go to events, but like a party or a night out or whatever. Like, this is my, one of my favorite greens ever. It even breaks my heart to kind of swatch it, just because then it's gonna get empty quicker. However, like, look at that. This, I don't have a single eyeshadow in my collection that does compare this or dupes this, because this is like a metallic, super glittery kind of unique shade. I'm gonna swatch some of the other shades. So I did go ahead and swatch all of the colors, but I just wanted you to see like the majesty of this palette. I think that this shade is the only one that I have never actually used on my eyes. It's just not really my cup of tea. It's sort of like this super cool toned gray, and you guys know I don't like grays. Grays is my least favorite color. If I could say one color I would never wear on my eyes, it would be gray. I would wear brown, I would wear beige, pink, blue, red, whatever, gray, uh-uh. But I would say this, if all of my makeup disappeared, I would buy, I don't know which matte palette I would purchase. I would probably purchase like a big palette with a lot of mattes in it. Don't know which one. Don't really want to think about it even. But I think that this is one of the first palette that I would repurchase so I could have something super glittery and intense on my eyes all the time. But that was all from me today, guys. I do hope you liked this video, and please don't forget to check out Jessica. And if you're new here, I would love it if you would subscribe. But if you did like this video, please give me a little thumbs up. If you did not enjoy this video, please give me a thumbs down, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye.